We're just about at the old fishing hole here. Go right in there. Jim's got a nice one. Looks like a nice one. He's out there. Not coming up.
Not gaining too much on it. I got a 4-pound leader, so I don't wanna.
There we go, Jim. Okay, Jim, bring them in.
Maybe down the limb there.
Is he stuck?
There's a couple big stumps down there, though.
Dave and Jim, 0, stumps 2.
Yeah.
Nice fish.
There he goes. We got a fish on. It's down deep. And he took that right by the boat.
Really?
Where he wants to go, because
about 7 o'clock here at Crane Prairie on the 18th of June 2015.
Yesterday we caught two fish and lost two fish. We got one more full day of fishing here before we leave back to home. Whoa! Emma's got one there. Whoa! That looks like a nice one, Jim. There we go.
Barbecue.
Well, good morning. 4:45 a.m. We're up and at 'em. Last day of fishing today. This is first morning light right outside our cabin. It's the 19th of June, 2015. Birds are singing. And we're hoping for a good day of fishing. This is a beautiful green prairie reservoir at about 5:30 in the morning. Fishing at our old hole here. It's cold. Hole.
It appears this sign was lovingly placed in the favorite fishing spot of an avid fisherman who lived between 1941 and 2000.
So we're ready to leave the old cabin, and we left it all cleaned up. This is a rustic cabin
It's $55 a night, and they've got brand new mattresses on the bed. They sleep well. Plenty of blankets to keep you nice and warm. They furnish towels and washcloths and firewood. And here's the dining area. And if you get cold, there's a nice stove. And a broom to sweep up the cabin when you leave. Well, that's it for this year. It's been fun fishing.
Of course, on the way back, they gotta stop at that snow cap drive-in in Three Sisters for a malt and a burger. What you having, Jim? A strawberry shake?
I am. A low-cal one.
Low-cal, that's right. I'm having a double cheese, double bacon burger. A little homemade fry sauce, made special at Snow Cap for Jim's burger. What kind of burger you having, Jim?
Just a deluxe burger.
Having a deluxe. Okay. Here's my burger. Looks good. Rum raisin and Kona coffee.
Here's the dish for you just in case it falls over.
Okay. Okay, Jim. Fishing! Fishing! You're running over his line! Is he on yet?
Huh?
Is he on yet? Oh, he's way out there, man. Is your line reeling in? Where'd that sinker come from on your line?
I don't know. Oh, it's a slider.
Oh, it's a slider, okay. See that? That came right towards the boat there. That's why you thought you'd...
I know it.
He was off. Man, good thing I brought my ruler. Good job. That herring worked.
Yeah.
Man, that's a nice one.
I've got about 32 and a half, best I can do, measure them.
Cool. Yeah, that boat almost ran over him.
Yeah.
I thought he did for a while.
Boy, he took that really well.
Nice one.
Yeah, very good. Here, let me get a picture with my cell phone. Okay, that's great, Jim. Well, what do you think? 800 pounds. Oh. That's the way to do it.
Twenty-four pounds.
Pretty nice fish. Boy, that's nice and bright. Sea lice on them. Well, it's Friday morning, September 18th, 2015. And Jim is ready to catch a fish. I can tell by the look on his face.
You're just about to hook into him.
Well, did you catch one when? About a week ago?
Friday. Monday.
Yeah. 15 pounder. And then you caught one a week before that, too. So we'll see what we get today. Quite a few people on the river today, mostly downstream. We're just a little bit of past Coyote Rock. Heading for the movie house. You guys do any good? Got one. Nothing. They're bobber fishing. Okay. The first one of the day was a 28-inch Chinook caught by yours truly. And there he is in the bottom of the boat. A little baby, but good eating. What do you think about that, Jim?
Great.
What do you think those seals were doing?
I don't know. Looks like
sure
they were
spitting in each other's eye.
Yeah.
Probably a love squabble. Yeah, they're still fooling around out there. Fighting over a fish, maybe? I think they got a fish. I think they got a fish and they're trying to kill the fish.
And if it's already dead, they're just breaking it up so they can eat it in small pieces.
That's what I think. See, I at least suspect to catch one now because I'm videoing. Never catch a fish while I'm videoing. Because I least expect it. Of course, when you least expect it, that's when it happens.
That's called the theory of most least expected results.
Today is October 1st, 2015. I'm here in the boat with Jim Young. This is another day of fishing on the Siletz River. Jim's got one.
Looks like a nice one, Jim. Wow, he's way out there.
Watch it there.
Jim, that is a nice one. You got a ruler?
Yeah. I was letting line out, and I hadn't clicked it yet. When he started taking line, I had my thumb on there.
Oh. Well, he hit it pretty hard. Wow, that must be about a 25 pounder or more. Pretty good, Jim. It's on a red and white spinner again.
About 24 pounds.
24 pounds, all right. Hold them up there, Jim, so I can get them on the video here. Wow, that is huge. Got to take a extra shot here. Looking good. Wow.
Somebody caught, oh my goodness.
Well, we did catch one.
You caught a big monster. How big is it? You weigh it yet?
Oh, that's a dandy.
Was it a male or a female?
It was a
quick
male.
Quick fish or a lure, yeah. Or trolling or what?
Trolling with the spinner.
Spinner? Super, duper, super. I've fished all year and haven't gotten, yeah, I got a 5-pound jack.
I'm going to go out this weekend.
Good morning, America. Today is October 14th, 2015. We're out here on the Siletz fishing with Jim and Lauren. Lauren's freezing over here, but he's hopeful of catching a fish on his herring.
Amen!
fish bite when you least expect 15,
it. 5.
And it's 15 and a half feet deep here. Jim is least expecting a fish to bite right now. Lauren doesn't care. But we'll see some fish maybe in the next scene here.
Where's that bee buck?
Already?
Already.
It's right up there behind Dave.
Got a net out.
Lauren's got one there. It'll be a while. Here, Jim.
Okay, I'm gonna stand up.
So you were just, did you were fishing any weight, Lauren?
Huh?
Fishing with any weight?
No. Right here.
Too big for the net?
Wow.
Hmm.
Let me see if no.
Still on?
No, you're still there.
How in the world did that happen?
Well, he hit the fish and run over and got underneath Jim's line.
Oh.
Take it out of gear, Jim.
What is that, a little jack?
A little silver. Well, Jim, I don't know. We're gonna have to find somebody else to run this out. Jeez. Talk about a foobar deal. First he knocks the fish off, and now I can't get the net out of the boat.
Well, it's all tied up.
Are you ready? Tell me when
you're
ready.
Yeah, I guess we're ready.
There.
You get it?
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh.
There you go.
Thank you.
That was a conundrum.
Yeah, well, that didn't hurt too bad, did it?
That was good teamwork, you guys.
That was a full bar, wasn't it?
It's a nice little silver, yep.
Yeah.
Nice little silver. Well, good teamwork, you guys. Yeah, he never got loose. He's pretty good.
Nice fish.
Yeah. Today is October 21st, 2015. We're on the Siletz this morning with Lauren Stratton and Jim Young. And we're gonna catch some big ones today, you guys. I hear an amen.
Amen!
All right. And it's a beautiful fall day. The sun is shining. Clear skies with a little high cloud overcast in some areas. Fog is lifting from the river.
Come on fishing. Got that net ready to go? Yeah, ready.
Well, we fished all day and haven't touched a fish yet, except for the one that Jim lost. Broke his snap swivel. That's a David fish. Just caught a little silver and now a Chinook. All right, you guys, it's your turn.
Well, if you quit hogging them all day.
So, Dave did catch a couple of them. Small Chinook and a silver. Not too bad for it. Dave's catch. That's it for the day. Now it's fish cleaning time. Well, today is October 27, 2015. Jim and Dave are here in the boat, least expecting a fish to be caught. We're trying to expect as least as we can, because when you least expect it, one's gonna hit. But the fish have been jumping. Going by the movie house again. And I'm
fishing with a quick fish, trolling with that. And Jim's trolling with a red and white spinner with a squid tied on. Oh, Jim, that was a good job of netting. That's a big one. Jim has got one here. Well, good old Dave lost that last one. Got too anxious with the net, broke the line. Was a small silver.
Sorry about that, Jim.
Well, here we are on the Great Siletz. November 15. Oh, bummer.
We just came out of the tavern. And Dave's having a little problem.
It's November 4th, 2015 on the Great Siletz. Fishing with us today is Jim Young, Lawrence Trenton. And Lawrence fishing with a herring, Jim's fishing with a red and white spinner, and I'm fishing with a quick fish. Same one I caught a 27 pounder on last time we were out. So we're gonna see what we're gonna do today. We've had a lot of rain in the last week, so we don't know how many fish are still down here. Hopefully we'll catch some fresh ones that are coming in today. But in about 2 weeks they say there's a big run coming in of larger fish, but it only lasts about 4 days, and then after that it's all over with for the fall fishing of salmon, unless you go up farther in the river. So hopefully the next scene you'll see is someone catching a fish. Hey, Lauren.
Hey, what?
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. Jim, are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm catching them.
Okay. I'm ready. Let's go for it. Okay, Lauren's got one here. What kind is that? Whoa. No, he's not. He's pretty bright. Seal damage.
Seal mark, Johnny. Ready? Let him go head first.
Whoa. There you go. Whoa, that's a nice one. Well, good job, you guys.
Thank you. Thank you, Jim.
That's a fair size one.
Yeah, 20, 25, maybe.
Jim is switching to a herring. It's red and white, didn't seem to be effective enough. Lauren's still fishing with a herring, and I'm fishing with a quick fish. Put a little toothpick in there to give it a nice little twist so she spins in the water. Little half hitch around the snout, two of them. There you go. Put about 3 ounces on there, and
so ends our trout and salmon fishing for 2015. The upcoming rains caused the salmon to race toward their spawning beds. It was a good time with Jim Young and Lauren Stratton, and hopefully we can get together again in 2016.
Okay, catch a big one, Jim.